everyone. Welcome to the Pampas shooting range. Osijek, Croatia is where we are. We're in the middle, almost the middle, of the second week of the European Championships. And we have an indoor competition for you to enjoy before we go outdoor for the trap competitions. There's the 25 meter pistol for women in this interesting, fascinating Eastern Croatian city, the largest city in the east in Slavonia. Fourth largest city in Croatia itself, population around 100,000, been around settlements here since about 1200. And the Pampas Shooting Club itself been in existence since 1784. And that's where we are, in that big white pavilion that's been put up especially for the European Championships. And of course, for the World Cup that is coming up at the end of June. Lots of COVID precautions in place. You've got to be tested every 2 days, making sure that people are sat at a safe distance from each other here inside. Lots of crosses on lots of seats just to let people know where you can and can't sit yourself down. Of course, lots of masks as well. This is the 25 meter pistol event details. 50 shots will end up telling us who has the gold medal. This gun has to be between a kilogram and 1400 grams. It is, of course, the old-fashioned money, the 0.22, the 5.6 millimeter. Lots of rules and regulations. The trigger pressure has to be to the rules, and it will be checked very thoroughly before, sometimes after as well. So, 8 athletes here looking to become European champion. About to start their sighting shots. We start at the top of the hour at 12 o'clock midday local time. Okay, Mayor is one of our athletes, the 24-year-old. We have a couple of Russian athletes. Russia, of course, been very strong throughout. Qualification was interesting. Certainly up bright and early. It started at 8 o'clock this morning when it was a little chillier than it is now. No need for a shoot-off. The 8th place athlete, Margarita Chernozova of Russia, 0.1 ahead of Anna Karaki, champion, of course, just missing out. And that was really important in more ways than one, not just the chance to be in the final, but also it meant that the Olympic quota place went to Margarita Chernozova. Everyone else in the final has claimed an Olympic quota place. So a good morning's work, whatever happens for the Russian athletes. Athletes. I'll introduce you to them shortly. A reminder of how this works as they get ready for their sighting shots. There's 10 series. If you stay in that long, 5-shot rapid fire. Each athlete with a single shot, hit or miss. A hit is 10.2 or higher. All athletes get 4 series of 5 shots. And then after the 4th series, 8th place athlete is decided and they leave. After the 5th series, the 7th athlete, and so it goes on. If there is a tie break, those athletes that are involved are tied together, they will have an additional series. And by the time we get to the 10th series, gold and silver will have been decided. You'll hear it ready. Attention, the red lights, 7 seconds, and the green for 3 seconds. And that is when you have to get your shot away. The screens are useful, COVID screens, but also to stop the ammunition hitting your near neighbour. Remember, we start in about 5 minutes' time here in Osijek, the biggest competition in any sport before Tokyo are in 1,500 athletes taking part, and all the finals being streamed on the IWSF internet resources, and obviously TV broadcasts as well. Do have some non-European athletes competing for minimum qualification scores. You've seen the Indian athletes around here, for example. They've come on a chartered flight, isolated, then taking part in qualification to get some practice. They'll be here again for the World Cup at the end of June. And it does just give athletes a chance to get some practice in. It's been difficult, hasn't it, with COVID, just before Tokyo gets underway. Here are our eight athletes then about to be introduced to us. We start on shooting position A. This is Sylvia Steiner from St. Johan. She came just outside the middle medals in the mixed team air pistol event, fourth. She'll be hoping for better here. She's had a World Cup gold to her name in Gabala 4 years ago now. Well, she has an air pistol team gold. Elena Kostovic, the 36-year-old, fourth in the air pistol individual final. Her husband and her 3.5-year-old daughter here watching. Veronika Major, up the road in Hungary. Our next athlete, the 24-year-old, world ranked number 9. And here's the woman with the Olympic quota place, Margarita Chernozova. Her pistol team silver already in her collection. Always ready with a smile, Monica Kasch. And a COVID compliant blown kiss as well. 38 years of age, of course, the Olympic Games silver medalist. Bit further back in her career, Mathilde Lemar, the 24-year-old of France, junior World Cup champion, a world champion rather, in 2014. Next up, Katalina Batarishkina, the 24-year-old, air pistol silver, and a couple of team medals as well. And next to her, Claudia Bresch on this far right-hand side, the 26-year-old Polish athlete. Our jury member in charge is from Finland. And our chief range officer is from nearby Slovenia and has been looking after all these finals. And this is the start list, the eight athletes looking for Olympic, looking forward to the Olympics, looking for Olympic quota places. That's already sorted, and looking to become the European champion. There's Kuna, our mascot. First appearance of the day for him as well. Not sure where he disappears off to at night. Oversized pine marten, I'm told. Okay then, he's making his way to somewhere more comfortable, I think. So remember, 10 series, 5 shot rapid fire, hit or miss, 10.2 or above is higher. And after the fourth series, we will see our first athlete leave. Time for these athletes to get themselves into their zone. Have the ammunition ready to load. Just the 3 seconds to get that shot away. And the target, just a big black circle. So you've got to know and be trusting in your process. This will be noisy. Fingers in ears or ear protectors on. Petrushkina just taking a while to get herself ready. You see the target in the distance. 25 meters away. It's a great skill these athletes have. And there we go. And it's Lamont, Patrashkina, Presh, and Chenuzova with the hit straight away. Patrashkina has been in great form, hasn't she, in air pistol. Three medals, two silvers and a gold. And she is in a joint lead, but it's a seven-way joint lead very early on. Chenuzova with three, Lamol with three. Patrashkina keeping up with them. Oh, it's excellent from the two Russians, who are top of the pile with four apiece. Veronica Mayor, surprisingly, just the one hit from her. No chance in this discipline to adjust your sights and make sure your grouping's right. It's just relying on your instinct, your process, and of course, the ability. So Chenuzova, Patrashkina, the two Russians top, three on three, and then Steiner, Bresch on two, and Mayor at the bottom with one. And she'll want to come roaring back in this second series. After the fourth series of just 20 shots, we start to lose athletes. Mayor next to Chenuzova. Alina Kostevich came fourth in the air pistol final, just outside the medals. And that's just the one World Cup gold to her name, the 39-year-old, inside the world top 50. And she has started well. Still the two Russians. Top of the pile at the moment, and Patrashkina and Chenuzova both shooting exceptionally well at the moment. Mayor, all of a sudden, is in her form as well. Steiner, again, not put a foot wrong so far in this second series. It's excellent from Steiner and Chenuzova, both with five out of five. And well, Mayor is still at the bottom of the rankings, but she is much more in touch now. A four-way tie in fifth. You see how it has all changed. Steiner up into third place. Mayor, Kostevich, Kash and Bresch all a little bit worried about the situation, I imagine. Here we go, our third series. Monica Kash, an Olympic Games silver last time out in Rio. I'm sure she'll be wanting to upgrade that if she can in less than 2 months' time. Russians are shooting so well, first and second by some distance at the moment. Bresch and Steiner. Lamol shooting well as well. The French woman, the 24-year-old. This is Mayor. Struggling a wee bit at the moment. Just the one out of three for her. Lamol shooting very well. Kash coming to the party as well. Patrashkina, well, has been excellent, hasn't she? Chenuzova, by her high standards, will be disappointed by three. The two Russians both scoring three in that series. Lamol and Kash coming closer with four. Remember, the Olympic quota place already decided, going to Russia, going to Chenuzova. And who will miss out here at the first time of asking our first athlete about to go? So our fourth series, we're now we'll get into the elimination stage of this competition. Major, the Hungarian, is the athlete in danger of going out first. But there's three athletes ahead of her. Major missing. Kostovic and Steiner also in danger here. Kash shooting well into third place. A share of third place with Lamolle, who's only hit the one. Rush shooting well, getting herself at the moment out of trouble. Major with two. There's a three-way tie at the bottom at the moment. And now Kostovic dropping down. Just the one hit from her. Oh, her daughter will be willing her to move up a little bit. And it is Kostovic. Just two hits out of a possible five for the 36-year-old. She got the air pistol team gold. She was fourth in the individual air pistol event, but it's not to be for her here. And she will have to go first in the 25-meter pistol event. Eighth place then for Alina Kostovic of Ukraine. So seven left, two on 11. Veronika Major and Sylvia Steiner, Russian still top. Tanuzova, who qualified eighth and last, is now top of the pile and finding some great form. Petrushkina, second on 14. Kash and Lamolle, who's on 13. But it is Major and Steiner who are in danger after this fifth series of going out. It may all change. Brett only a point above. Steiner starts well. Major not so well. Kasha's got to be careful here. She's missed the first two. It's still Major who's two adrift at the moment. And she's not hitting anything at the moment, and she's now two adrift. Looks very much like it's the Hungarian who is going to make way. One more shot to go. One, the difference between her and Steiner. And it's not going to happen for Major. She hit her last two, but Steiner hit her fifth target to make it three out of five and stay in the competition. And so it is Veronika Major, the 24-year-old. She has World Cup gold in this discipline, but it's not to be here. She'll take her place next to her coach and will take seventh in this 25-meter pistol competition. Six left in. Now it's Steiner we're going to keep an eye on because she's one behind Bresch. The Russians still shooting well. Lamolle there or thereabouts as well. Here we are live then inside the rifle and pistol pavilion. Some gaps where athletes have left. Sylvia Steiner on that far left-hand side might well soon be making her way as well. She was just outside the medals in the mixed team air pistol. But she starts well. So does Bresch, importantly for the Polish athlete. Steiner misses, Bresch doesn't. Two the difference then. Steiner in a bit of a problem here. Well, it's one now. One the difference. It's getting very tight, isn't it? Two more shots to decide who takes sixth place here. Bresch misses. Steiner misses. It's going to go down to this last shot. Steiner needs to hit. And she is unable to do that. Bresch with the hit to take it to an advantage of two. And Steiner it is, who ends up in sixth place. No medal so far in these championships for her. She'll be disappointed not to have progressed further. Five left in this competition, and she makes her pistol safe and then heads to sit by her coach. A little shrug of the shoulders, a little wry smile, not to be for the 39-year-old. She takes her place next to her coach and takes sixth place. Well, there's been a few changes. We were watching the bottom. Chinosova is still top, but only by a point from Monica Karsh, who shot really well, 4 out of 5 in the last series. Le Moll is also on 20 targets. Petrushkina down into fourth place, but only one behind the French and German athletes. So tight, very tight. Bresch and Petrushkina might well be battling it out to stay in this competition. 3 points between all five. Good start from Bresch. Petrushkina missing, so they're level on 19. Bresch again doing well. Petrushkina able to stay in the hunt with a hit. Looking for a fourth medal, the Russian. And now she goes one ahead of Bresch. Oh, it's very tight, isn't it? It's going to go down to this last shot. Anything could happen here. Oh, and it's going to be a shoot-off between Petrushkina and Bresch. Bresch hitting a last one, Petrushkina not. So 4 for Bresch, 3 for Petrushkina. And those are the fine margins that can give you success or failure. So then, just the two athletes in this shoot-off. They'll have a series to themselves, next to each other, on the far right-hand side of our arena. Here we go then, just the two athletes in this, head-to-head. This is a shoot-off to stay in this competition. They both started well. Oh, my word, step by step. These two are not being separated just yet. Oh, and now Petrushkina has the advantage. Bresch bring it back here, neither athlete hitting, so what can they do in this last shot? Oh, and it's 3 out of 3 for both these athletes. Bresch rescuing right at the end, and we will go again. So a chance for these athletes just to get the ammunition sorted for the next series, clear their minds. Everybody else just having to wait for this conclusion. They'll be in their own little bubble, not worrying about the battle beneath them for fourth and fifth place. Remember this to see who drops out in fifth place. Petrushkina, their pistol silver. Can she stay in the hunt for a 25-meter medal here as well? Bresch, 2 years her senior, but with less experience. European Championship silver in 2017 and a European Championship gold in air pistol here in Osijek 2 years ago. That's what she has achieved, so she knows this range well. Oh, Badryshkina is starting really well. Breshi in a spot of bother here. Oh, I think that is it, done and dusted. Excellent from the Russian. The athlete from Omsk showing real accuracy here. Just the one left. It's not going to matter. And a final consolation green for Claudia Bresch, but it was excellent, 4 out of 5. Excellent shooting from Badryshkina. So the Polish athlete has to make way. 5th place for her in this 25-metre final. Okay, 4 left. Badryshkina, for all those heroics, is still a point adrift of those in second place. Chernozova, Lamol, it's Karsh, who shot really well in that last series, who is ahead by 1. Another series, and we'll know who's in the medals and who's missing out. Badryshkina needs to keep her A game going here. Lemon with a miss, so they're equal on 23. Well, again, Lemon is missing, Badryshkina is not. Makes it a little bit more interesting. Back to level. 2 more to go. Oh, Lemol 1 ahead. And Chernozova has dropped down. She only shot 2. And so from being top of the pile, all of a sudden we were watching Lemol and Badryshkina. It is the other Russian athlete who has to make way. Well, she qualified in 8th. She was top for so long, Margarita Chernozova. Down from 2nd into 4th. 25 targets for her. She had an air pistol team silver. It's not going to be a medal for her. It looked like it was going to be, didn't it? But everybody else shot well. She had an off series, and that's what can happen. So we know our medalists. Got a couple of Olympic medalists in the hall. How did you do, Tim Gerber? Just had a couple of seats away from me. Olympic Games bronze in Rio, and Celine Gourbeville, of course, the Olympic Games silver in London. Well, they didn't qualify so well today, 30th and 18th respectively, so they're watching on and they'll be interested to see how this plays out. At the moment, 26 for the Lemol. Karsh just 1 ahead of them. Lemol drops down into the 3rd place at the moment. 27 each now is Badryshkina. Takes her turn to miss. Lemol now ahead of Badryshkina. This is very tight, isn't it? Karsh only shot 1 so far. She's equal with the French woman. Lemol looking good, going into the lead from 3rd to 1st. And it's the last shot here with Badryshkina, 1 behind. And Karsh makes sure that she stays in the hunt, and it is Russia who will take the bronze medal. Well, it's her 4th medal. She's had an excellent European Championships, hasn't she? A bronze medal to go with her air pistol silver medal. Remember, she will go to the Olympic Games in very good nick indeed. Well, Mathilde Lamalle has time to run perfectly, hasn't she? She's now one ahead of Monica Kasch, and it's Germany against France. Russia unable to mount a challenge for gold. Right, our last series, unless we go to a shoot-off, of course. Kasch, who struggled early on, but has come good as this competition has progressed. Lamalle, who was in danger of dropping out, is now in poor position for the gold. Both start well. Veteran German coach taking notes. Well, two out of two. No one's blinked first. Not yet, anyway. Goodness me, this is going to be tight. Still Lamalle with a one-shot advantage. So this next one is crucial. Oh, excellent from Lamalle. Kasch misses. So it is going to be gold for France, but they've got one more target to go. And a 5 out of 5 to finish. What a great run. A 4 and then a 5 from Mathilde Lamalle. And the French woman takes the gold here in Osijek. Oh, goodness me. She wasn't even on the radar until about 3 series ago. And all of a sudden, she put the afterburners on. I don't think she can quite believe it. Well done to Monica Kasch as well. Again, time to run really well, didn't she? The Olympic Games medalists in Rio taking a silver here like she did at the Olympic Games. And remember, the bronze going to Vatalina Batrashkina. And the French contingent just down by me, absolutely delighted with their charge as it was, up into the gold medal position. Exciting stuff here in Osijek. And these are our medalists, just waiting to see them, all three of them together. And there we go, Vatalina Batalshkina of Russia with the bronze, Monica Kasch of Germany with the silver, and well done to Mathilde Lamalle of France, who takes the gold.